Now let's go to someone who's never, ever going to break the cycle. They're going to be trapped in a death loop until they die. Because they're insane. For the people who don't like the Pickles content, maybe tune out for the next hour. I don't know how long this is going to take. We got a content dump. Pickles has been surprisingly very active in the past. It's very entertaining, though. So if you like the Pickles stuff, please stick with us. Before we get to the stream she did with Jacob, where she did a solo stream, which was pretty funny.
Yeah, this is crazy, right?
This is, she's just... Yeah, so it starts with her. Well, you'll see. Let's go for it.
Holding us hostage.
How you doing? It's me, GP, as always. Also known as Outdoors...
Perimeter Perez. Stephen King.
Welcome to my channel. How are you guys
Perimeter
doing
Pascal,
evening?
Or whatever the fuck you call them.
I just got home from chairing my... recovery group.
She's not doing this.
No. I think this is what's just fucking crazy about Pickles, right? Is like sometimes there's truth. And I think she is telling the truth about the recovery thing, and I will explain that when the time gets to.
Okay. Do you think she's running it?
No, she's probably not running it. That's probably a total lie.
I seriously
doubt she's running it, but I think she is going, and I'll explain.
Maybe she helps make coffee.
Yeah, something.
And sit down and
put out the chairs.
And I will update you guys on everything that's going on in my life at the moment.
Nothing changed.
Before anybody
in our
else
life.
Can run their little Bitwave or whatever.
She's talking about us?
Yeah, dude. She shouts. She gives a Bitwave shout out.
Yeah, nice. Old school.
That's just fucking rattling around in her brain. Bitwave's been gone for like 2 years almost, maybe.
We have like destroyed her brain.
Yeah. Yelts can run their little Bitwave or whatever channel that they go by. So just come on in and let's chat.
So this is great. I truncated it. She keeps putting up these signs. She decided she's not going to continue until somebody says hello. And of course, there's no one in chat. This goes on for, no joke, probably 45. There's probably 45 minutes of silence of her just being completely silent, holding up these signs.
This is brand new. She has never done this before.
Yeah.
Like, she is holding us. Want to give you all an update on what's going on. No one fucking is here. So why would you, you know what I mean? Like, if no one's here, you're saying it to no one. I love how she's always just like, hi guys. I wanted to get, and no one's in there. It's just us.
Oh, just wait, Laughing Cucumber.
Dude, you could play this to like what's a song? Like some new pop song you could play where it's just like and it shows her just changing the signs where it's just like I was abused my whole life.
Oh, I was gonna the Bob Dylan video where he's just like on a street corner, just like holding up the lyrics or whatever and just like putting them on the ground.
Yeah, something like that, yeah. Yeah, no, she's like actually probably a little bit losing it. We've destroyed her brain.
What was left of it?
Yeah, but again, just get off the internet. Okay.
There was probably someone in chat, but like it was just her and she didn't realize it. You know, there's like one
or
viewer
it's
and she
just
didn't.
Like somebody that just kind of knows about her tangentially and is just like looking and just like, wow, this is crazy.
Yeah, her roommate is fucking nuts. And I wish he would be. He's hard to understand.
He's going to be in some of the video.
He's in some of this one, too. Half of this video is just them. Okay, I don't know how long. This is like 7 minutes out of like a 3-hour stream that I had.
Like, dude, them just going back and forth is pretty good.
Yeah. When you can understand him.
Yes.
Hey! Till someone talks in here, LOL. Yeah. Well, I wanted to update you guys on what's been going on in my life.
Why are you talking about me? That's why I run my mouth. Fucked up.
Had a group tonight.
Just want to see him like fucking just slugger some point.
Oh yeah. And all right off.
I actually had a lady come in.
This is great. Just again, she does the thing where she fucking
doxes
and she like actually doxes this woman.
If you guys are familiar kind of. With Spotify.
Wait, is this the lady with the roommate who's an alcoholic?
I don't know, but
if not, then she doxes another lady.
This woman apparently, this woman has a podcast.
No.
And no. No, and this is why, okay, well, I'll let her explain it here. Because
you can find her live stream or her podcast over there on Spotify and Amazon Music. They are Daughters of Valor. Go over there, give them a check them out. She is an honorably discharged Marine.
Oh, I thought it was like a Nazi.
Who was injured.
Daughters of Valor.
in a Humvee explosion.
This woman's an addict going to these meetings.
She was medically honorably discharged after 13 years.
Oh, and she's hooked on fucking narcotics?
Probably.
Once a Marine,
yeah, probably.
Pickles is just like, there's this woman at this... recovery meeting.
Country, she's a wicked heroin addict now. She's got to go to our meeting.
Semper Fi. I will be
Semper Fi.
On her podcast soon. She's
no.
going to be over here on my live streams and
Hell
my
yes.
podcast over on Podbean.
That's, I cannot
Everything
fucking
has,
wait.
Like, come around full circle.
Okay, so I guess I cut it out, but she says the woman's name. And I looked her up. I looked up the podcast. It's a real podcast. It's sort of like it's exactly like she described. And I thought, well, Pickles probably just like found this thing and it's just saying, you know. But she said the woman's name and I found the woman's LinkedIn in Hillsville, Virginia. So, so that's why I'm saying. So the recovery thing probably is true. She probably is going to recovery meetings. And she met this woman.
Woman comes on Gorilla, the woman about is Pickles the leader of the group.
Well, that's if she ever even comes on the stream. So yeah, so Pickles probably is telling the truth about that. See, it's crazy when you find it because you just assume she lies about everything.
There's got to be some lies. We got to figure out where they are.
In my life,
spot the lies.
I got promoted at my other job.
Well, probably this right here.
Trainer, where I'm at.
Dude, the recovery program
Which
isn't a job.
What it means?
She's probably talking about Hardee's.
In layman's terms.
No, of course, Pickles didn't have cancer. We're the ones that exposed it.
Well,
she didn't have cancer.
She maybe had cancer once.
Years ago. Yeah.
Yeah, but that wasn't now, or within the last couple.
Is I train the newbies that come in, and if I get this,
yeah, I didn't include it, but she says the woman's name, Jacob. It's like you're not, and then she brings it up later again too. Like she's like, I think I'm gonna, you know, film one of my recovery meetings. It's like you can't do that.
Stop, like stop saying that. You're not gonna do that. So stop saying.
I will be doing.
Because I want to see her do it.
Position.
No joke. Like, as sick as it is, I want to see her do something.
The girl that I was
fucked up.
Talking about who does the podcast, she is a manager at this other place, and she's willing to pick me up every night and take me to work and bring me home. And as you guys probably know, I am no.
She's not going to want to do that for very long.
Longer doing streams with Jake Husden. Good luck on your future endeavors, Jake. The little group that has been aggravating the hell out of me for the past 2 years.
Yeah, going on almost three.
Strikes again.
I've already made my deposition.
Nice. I love it.
And my statements are already dealt with the courts and with the attorneys.
They got what they needed from Pickles.
Fucking crazy.
So if you don't stop doing whatever you're doing, you're harassing people, you're taking people's content and using it for your own, saying, oh, it's freedom of speech.
It's talk over
free
content.
To use.
She's such an idiot.
It's not fair use. It is not.
It's not
Let
fair
Let me warn
at all.
You ahead of time if you're over there sniping my channel.
Why are you warning us? I thought we're already being sued.
Yeah, like this.
Well, there's no more warnings, Pickles. This is an illegal thing now. We can't just be like, oh, okay, we'll stop doing it and the lawsuit's dropped, right? Maybe in magic cuckoo cucka land, but.
You need to stop. And you can.
She's
so
desperate.
You can cut it out of whatever you want, but this is not fair use of anybody's content. There are quite a lot of people that are standing behind me that have already stated
Hoppity Bonkta.
Crap. They're tired of their channels being sniped, them getting harassed. And it is not Joker that is filing this claim. Let me tell you that right now.
Well, tell us who it is then.
Now, she will in the next stream.
Me and Joker have talked. Me and him have worked out our issues. Due to
I'm sure they talked. I'm sure she got a DM saying, is this fucking thing real or platform. You got to tell me now, Pickles?
There was-
Well, it's not real.
Yeah, I already made myself look like a fucking asshole by believing it. Just off the cuff and like fucking...
A group that he was affiliated with that was putting people up to doing what they were doing. Me and him have
encoded speech. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That group that was doing what theys was doing to him, and he's was dealing with his own thing with his own group.
You guys might get to see me do maybe one content of the group meeting.
Yeah.
You will not get to see the group, but you'll get to see me. I'm not.
They're just gonna be just like she's gonna be like someone's gonna be like speaking like I've been struggling like really bad lately. I just be like, hey Dragons 88, how's it going? Yep.
Yeah, Cross of Iron 88, yep, another heroin addict. Yep, we got a lot of them down here. Yeah, I want him to speak up. Can you speak up? My chat can't hear you.
I'm from Indiana. We are.
Oh, this is some of her famous. She is just so brain melted. This is some more of Pickles. Pickles' geography skills. Listen, this is nuts.
Group meeting.
She's from
you
Indiana.
You will not get to see the group, but you'll get to see me. I'm not. I'm from Indiana. We are the lower state. We are under Virginia.
Indiana is under Virginia. Skillet Lover 223.
Doesn't Indiana touch a Great Lake?
Yes. Or borders? It's
very small.
Does Indiana even touch Virginia? I don't think so.
No, I don't believe
so. No, it doesn't.
I think it touches Illinois and Ohio, correct? Illinois. It's next to Illinois.
Indiana's next to Illinois. Yeah, it's. Look how great. Like
it might touch West Virginia, maybe.
It's under Virginia of Australia. It. Yeah.
It sure as hell isn't fucking below it.
We are the lower state. We are under Virginia.
The hell.
She's like so. This is like threatening.
Okay, but even if she's in West Virginia is above Virginia, 100%.
West Virginia doesn't touch, West Virginia's kind of, part of it's above Virginia.
You need to go.
Or like, no. It doesn't matter. Indiana is not below Virginia.
West Virginia sits on top of Virginia. Virginia on the left side of it.
Yeah. West Virginia.
So she's on top of Virginia. So even she's just saying we're below Virginia. So like.
See, that's right there. That's right.
Pickles is exposing us for being retarded. Kentucky does seem nice.
Say anything. I've got a little genius of my own.
That I don't have custody of.
My.
And he's taking 4 college classes on top of regular school. And as soon as he graduates from high school, he's going right straight to Microsoft because he's going to graduate college.
That's so awesome.
She's confused because he's taking college level classes in high school. Like that's a thing, right?
Yeah.
But she thinks that also means that he's attending college. Like,
and he's going to graduate at the same time. And he's, look at those eyes.
Yeah. When
he's going right to Microsoft.
And then he's going to Microsoft?
Yeah, is his name Renesh?
I can't say anything. I've got a little genius of my own.
Programming BattleBots with the trailer.
College classes on top of regular school. And as soon as he graduates from high school, he's going right straight to Microsoft because he's going to graduate college.
Has he been outside?
Yeah. We didn't have computers until what, the late 80s?
About 87.
Yeah, I don't think computers were a thing until 87, I think.
Like, yeah, I think you're at the. I saw the first one at the Consumer Electronics Show in 1986, I believe.
God, what is the combined IQ of these two?
Late 80s.
I think I also saw Doki Doki Panic rebranded as Mario 2 there that year. For the American release of the NES.
But look, we growed up.
I just come out. I didn't know that houses had bathrooms until 1986.
Shut the fuck up.
I hate that shit. I hate that. That shit bugs me so much. It's like, bitch, it's 2023. There's nothing rural going on.
You were born in 1976. Shut your fucking dumb fucking toothless mouth.
Yeah.
I didn't even know houses had baths. You grew up with a bathroom, idiot.
Shut up. Yeah, you grew up with everything we all had.
Who are you, fucking Gigi Allen growing up in a fucking cabin with no water? Yeah. You're like, shut the fuck up.
Hey, guys.
Yeah, you grew up in
Shit. Yeah. My goof. There we go.
We didn't have no running water in our house.
No.
So, shut the fuck up. We had to go outside and manually pump water.
Cottage at the pond has running water that we can pump from the lake, and we've done that. My grandfather set that up in the 50s. So this bitch needs to shut the fuck up. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
they had running water.
There's people in chat who are like a few years younger than her. Think about that. Apparently, she has lied about her age, though. But she I don't think she's much older than 50. At the latest.
Heated up and have no running.
She's the same age, allegedly, as Michael Ray Bauer. She's a year younger than Bauer.
Water in our house.
Allegedly.
We didn't.
Like
we had to go outside and manually pump water. And we had to heat it up with the wood burning stove.
Fucking
my son
nuts.
Not let anybody.
Yeah, no fucking way. You had to heat the water up with the stove in 1976 and pump the water from the well.
I just don't understand liars like that. I mean, it's obviously she has a personality disorder, but she never ceases to amaze me. And it's really going to blow me away with the next video.
Dude, our grandparents could have been lying to us if they said some shit like that.
I'd be like a bit skeptical. Like, yeah, skeptical.
Okay, sure, Gramp. You're just teaching us a lesson. Yeah, I'm sure you really did that. You know what I mean? Like, where it's like, maybe he did. Who knows? He probably didn't. And it's just like, we don't know. It was the 50s. Like, how do I know if he was fucking pumping his own water? I don't fucking know. He told, like, you know what I mean? Yeah.
The bathroom.
What? That ain't nothing to take into the bathroom. You sit in the bathroom, your damn 13-year-old daughter goes to the bathroom.
Oh, this guy's, he's pretty based.
There's 50, 60-year-old men sitting there jerking off. I don't know. What I'm saying is it's just, there's something wrong in the neighborhood.
Yeah. Listen close. I had to turn the volume up. What he says here is just.
What is he saying about jerking off?
He's talking about trans people using bathrooms. Listen closely to what he says here, because it is just, and she goes along with it. It is just totally incorrect.
Mr. Rogers should have didn't teach a class to right. That neighborhood burnt the fuck up. I love talking. Do you know Mr. Rogers, Marine?
Yeah.
Completely tattooed from head to toe.
That's why he always wore long sleeves.
Was he?
Mr. Rogers was not a Marine. He went to college. He was a Presbyterian minister. He went to college for theology.
That's like some crazy urban legend.
That's like some stupid urban legend like some boomers believe on like Facebook or something.
Yeah.
Mr. Rogers was tatted. It's
funny. He was actually a Navy SEAL sniper. 300 confirmed kills.
Yeah, it's like something you see on E-Bomb's World. Funny junk.
A restraining order.
They're just finding out about it.
In hell, I can't go to hell. So, because
don't say that, Pickles.
I tried to use all four of my kids as Satan's kids. It did it to me again. My fucking phone.
It's that. Oh, I didn't get the video up yet of the one you sent earlier. And yeah, I have not. I have only watched a little bit of this, so I'm quite excited.
Hey, what's going on, Pickle?
I thought Frendo just didn't like Christmas trees.
Frendo doesn't like anything. Frendo doesn't like fun. He lives in Utah. He's even worse than the desert.
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on, Kiggle?
Hey, Jake. Sorry, I worked early this morning until 4 o'clock this afternoon and fell asleep. Got promoted at work. Been running a program on Thursday.
She's been saying she's been promoted for like a few months now. By the way.
Forever. And is it this recovery program?
Yeah.
Thursdays. Called Recovery Through Christ. It's like a 12-step program with Bible verses and stuff like that, and I run it.
Giggle, you reached out to me recently.
Yeah.
She said she wanted to apologize or whatever.
It sounded like she wanted to clear the air, and I've always told you, I never really had an issue with you, Giggle. I thought you were coming at me. That was the only reason I joked about it.
I went after a bunch of people because of listening to everybody dealing with that little group that's been attacking other people, including me, that's been after me for the last 2 years. I opened my mouth and said some things out of anger.
It's all over the place.
Yeah, can't.
I really didn't mean. I'm probably sure they probably won't talk to me no more. But yes, I am sorry for things that were said, Jacob. Jake likes to listen to, and I told you this, Chris.
I love this.
He's back.
She's so wrong.
Out with Aaron and all them from Steel Toe. He likes to listen to them.
No, he's not.
Yeah, she thinks that Jake is back. Like, it's so great how wrong she is about everything.
He's not back with them.
Chris, can we break?
He is hanging back around with Aaron and.
Wow, she just fucking on a water's back. Just doesn't even.
It's like no, he
and now I've been listening to TOD and.
When did you and Jake stop talking recently?
Apparently, Steel Toe has been listening to us. They've been telling Jake, and then that Jake has been telling Pickles stuff. Not the lawsuit, just stuff.
Couple weeks now.
Couple weeks.
Yeah.
Why did you guys stop talking?
I have no idea. I was,
crazy.
Blocked me and he ended up banning me from his channel. And I was like, what the hell did I do now? I went over to his Twitter and I was like, what did I do? this time, Jake. And he said in big, bold letters, leave me the fuck alone, you liar.
That's great. I love that. I love that, Jake. I love that, Jake. That's so awesome. He also emailed us and just said, the lawsuit's not real. Like, yeah, no shit, Jake.
Jacob, like, do you know by any chance what it was that, like, Jacob was finally... Did someone say something to him? Was it him watching one of our videos?
Yeah,
what was it that finally made Jacob or Jake, like, fucking... Jake Husband realized that it was that she was lying to him again.
And I'm again. Okay, what did I do? So I was like, okay, whatever.
I'm assuming, and this may be just me assuming and making an ass of myself. I'm assuming it had to do with the court case.
This is so great what she says.
If
that had nothing to do with him. That had nothing to do with him.
Did he think he had anything to do with it, though?
Okay, you told him.
He was sending me shit about TOD, and I was sending it off to the attorneys. And, hell, they went after me. They went after him. They
look
went
how after she goes.
Rocco. They went after Joker. They went after... a lady named Peppermint Patty. hell, the whole thing is going at them over the roll-ups and other people.
The roll-ups.
Done talkovers over their TV about their shows.
Yeah. I could see.
It has nothing to do with us anymore.
Well, did it ever have anything to do with you guys, though? Besides the fact that they covered you guys on the video, did the lawsuit ever have anything to do with Rocco or Jake or yourself?
No. They went after them for bigger fish. And
it's totally not.
Isn't it great just watching her just run in circles?
Because I'm not getting no money out of it. Do what?
I thought you had said that Rocco started the lawsuit.
No.
I got footage of you saying that.
I said they went after Rocco.
Are you talking about when she was on Jake's show and said she told Jake?
To just sit here and just lie when they're just like, we have footage.
He started it. That's
what I have seen is her saying to Jake that Rocco started the lawsuit. And I've talked to Rocco. This is what I was telling you. I've been cool with you forever. That's why I introduced you to Rocco, because I thought you guys would do a good show together. And
indeed they did.
Yes. It was very, very awesome. Like,
no, she keeps talking about this lawsuit thing that's not real, and like I understand why he had to separate himself from it too. And I think Jake did the same thing recently. But I don't think they were doing it to be mean. I just think they felt like somebody was.
My roommate, he sat here every time Jake would bring it up.
Now the roommate's like involved in the lies too.
Jake only knew about it because of you, Google. He had no idea about it until you told him about it. Nobody was sending him letters or. He didn't know who any attorneys were or anything like that. Like, somebody had to give him information about this. Nobody was telling Jake about it. Even if.
Dude, you could fucking like show her the video of her. Like, we have it. And she'd still just deny it.
She'd be like, no, I didn't say that. That's not me.
He saw it on TOD.
Well, they never really had anything to do with Jake except for whenever they were following GP around.
Well, no, exactly. Jake was in their Jake was in their Discord.
That is Jake true. He wasn't. That's right. Jake was in their Discord.
She tries to like, Discord.
And then tried to act like he wasn't.
Snake on Jake Husband.
I was just doing it to play nice.
yeah. He would sit there and tell me off camera and off.
What's up, Total Dick?
You were in their Discord. You were in their channel. You were.
What?
Hanging out with them,
I'm in their Discord. I watch their channel, And yeah, I talk to them on occasion. I've never given them a single clip of anybody. And they've never taken a single clip from my show.
No, they've never taken, that's what's fucked up. They've never used one clip from Jacob's show. Like,
I have,
No,
they never will. I have episodes with Rocco. I have episodes with you.
Well, we are now. Guess you,
well, he does say they're going to take this show.
Access to it. They go, we know we do.
Jacob does say they're going to take this show because of what you've been
they
saying.
They don't care. It's the people that are drawing attention to themselves and want to play the game. They don't. They know exactly. I'm not going to really play it as much. I mean, they might have some fun with it. I mean, and more power to them.
You're not going to get mad at them. That's what they want.
Yeah, I can't really get angry.
But the thing was, Jay kept bringing it up, and my roommate kept telling me off camera, behind the camera, he kept going like this.
Yeah, don't talk about it. Because he would bring it over.
I love how the roommate just thinks it's totally real, too. She's like, just gaslit him into thinking that.
Yeah, dude, and they're about to blame the reptile lady.
Like, other people on the panel, and it was like, more or less set her ass up. Dude, like, she was running her mouth about it. Man, yeah.
Dude, I love that they probably talk about this.
Say that again. I couldn't hear him.
Her and her roommate.
I thought I told her to stop, but they won't. The lizard one, right?
Who was setting who up? I couldn't really hear him.
Jake. It was like Jake was trying to set me up. Him and the reptile lady.
Jake was in TOD's Discord and yada yada. So yeah, did they put him up to this lawsuit thing to keep telling her about it and yeah, run with it and this and that?
No.
I started to feel. He kept sitting there bringing it up and I was like, Jake, I can't talk about it.
That is true. Jake did keep bringing it up constantly. You
know, he did keep bringing it up. It was awesome.
You tell him it's not real. Why didn't you just tell him it's not real? It doesn't involve you.
Because I'm.
Oh.
I wasn't involved in any of that. I was told the case was real. This is what's happened. They were contacted by attorneys, this, that, and the other. And I was like,
our mind is breaking.
Wow. Jake was talking about that fuck you money. He was looking at jet skis and shit.
Yeah,
you pause that. Can you play that back? Can you play that back?
Jake talking about
this is like my favorite part of the whole video.
And I was like, okay.
Mm. Oh, I know, because Jake was talking about that fuck you money. He was looking at jet skis and shit.
Was he really looking up jet skis? Jake's gonna get.
Isn't that the best? Isn't that the best part?
Oh, poor Jake.
Oh, no, he ripped that dude.
Poor simple right. Jake.
I don't remember that one.
Yeah, I know. Yeah,
he thinks he's getting money. He's fucking pissed. He thought he was getting money, and now she's like...
That's what he's really pissed off most about, is that not just that she lied to him, but she lied to him and he's not getting a jet ski.
Oh, those first couple streams, they were talking about how we were going to have to fucking pay out the ass. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
She was leading that charge.
Yeah,
he really thought there was a lawsuit going on. I don't think TOD tricked him. So let me ask you an honest question. What would you be willing to do to make the TOD stuff stop forever?
Like, God only knows.
Does it really drive you nuts?
It's gotten to a point in my life where I don't care what the hell they do.
I don't know why it's so funny. We're never gonna stop.
It's never gonna stop.
And she fucking knows.
I'm doing my thing. I'm happy with what I'm doing.
Wouldn't you like to put it all to an end, though?
I don't. I can go up on there.
She's learned to accept it, Jacob. She's like, she's just, you know, yeah.
And say, you know, hey. This is what's going on. This is what's happening in my life. You know.
Would you ever be willing to actually talk to them online?
Not really, because it don't do anything.
We already know. Yeah.
Have you talked to them online before, like on a show?
No.
I'm like, no, okay, okay. I didn't think you ever had.
Okay.
Now, Giggle, were they was TOD the same people, or I think I might be thinking of somebody else, that they said they wanted to, like, get you an RV, and as long as you agreed to film your adventures driving around your town, they would buy an RV for you. Was that them?
No.
That was
I was like, I didn't think that was TOD, but I remember you mentioning it.
I was like, that was like a year and a half ago.
It's the whole point. It don't matter. I can show proof of everything. I can show all receipts of everything.
No, you can't.
And it won't do any good with these people.
Well, like I said with Jacob before, I thought you had already done like a show where you were on there with, and you had like a discussion or a argue, you know what I mean? Like a,
yeah,
not a discussion, what do you call it? Like a debate. I thought you already did like a debate show with TOD at one point.
Me and Joker did a live together. And Joker said, you know, you can't fake cancer. You can't. Because I've got the scars
to
show where I've had the surgeries.
Right.
I mean, okay. my mom's had cancer. Somebody could fake it. You could have scars and call it something else. I mean, that's 100% plausible. I'm just saying the scars wouldn't be true. Like my mom had thyroid cancer. I sat with her for years when she went through chemo for it, and now she has to take drugs the rest of her life to regulate what her thyroid used to do after she got it removed. It'd be hard to fake that to the people around you, but on the internet you could fake it if you wanted to.
Now, Giggle's defense,
people do those things. I'm not even saying you are. What I'm saying is people could fake those things.
Right.
Now TOD did even admit on one of their streams back in the day that yes, GP was sick, yada yada, or whatever. That no, she wasn't faking being sick or whatever at that point. They just say you pretended later on down the line or whatever. It's from my understanding.
Yeah, we don't deny that she's had cancer once. It could be a survivor, but this latest batch with the wig phase.
The wig phase.
But
that's crazy.
The thing is, how did you meet
Jake
Hudson? I had non-Hodgkin's lymphoma in my neck. So I have no lymph nodes in my neck.
So you have to take pills every day then, yeah.
I have to take pills every day, yes. Yeah. My immune system is compromised.
My integrity is compromised.
I get sick, I end up in the emergency room.
Now, how did you meet Jake Hudson originally? Because that's how we met you, was through Jake.
I met Jake Hudson in DLive, another
platform. DLive? Of course, because he's on all platforms. You know, he'll send me a link with nine of the platforms he's on.
Yeah.
So he just saw you on a show, or you saw him, or what? Or I guess he saw you.
I had seen
him. This is so funny what she says.
And he was talking about, he has autism and things of that nature. So I went in.
Pickles saw him and she said, ooh, look at this mark.
Yeah.
You know, I have
someone dumber than I am.
A family that has
autism. Maybe not, though. Jake's probably a little bit smarter.
They are fully functioning autistic.
Right.
So I went in and I
welcomed him into
DLive.
A fully functioning. She called Jake a fully functioning autistic.
He is not. Back with Steel Toe, Aaron, whoever, in any shape.
Listen to this. This is
nothing to do with him because they got doxxed and they got raided by the police and they got swatted or whatever. Yeah, because he was responsible for giving their address out to the people who did it, allegedly. I don't know whether it's true
anything,
or not. But
anything you've recently seen from Steel Toe where they talk about Jake is clearly covering it because he was on the Opie and Anthony stuff.
Right. He's been on Opie and Anthony. Like, remember Opie and Anthony, the radio show? He's been on Opie's show.
Yeah. Yeah. Jake's hit the big time.
And that's why they covered it. They don't talk to Jake.
Yeah. Just, it's all DLive. It all goes back to DLive.
Aaron M. Holtz.
Oh, yeah.
Did you hear what she just said? Go rewind it.
Jake.
Go back.
If you watch the intro,
Aaron M. Holtz.
Yeah, the steel toe.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
After they just said he hasn't been hanging out with them, she just goes, he's been hanging out with Aaron M. Holtz.
I just know that they don't want him around there unless there's some secret shit going on backstage. You know, I don't know.
Trying to bring back the viewers.
Would you be willing to do a show with Rocco again?
No,
I have no qualms with Rocco.
Rocco wouldn't do that. Hey, no. Rocco wouldn't do that.
No, I'm just saying, like, would she come on with Rocco over on your show or somebody else's show or whatever.
I'm just clarifying in case anybody watches this later. I don't think Rocco would do that.
Don't think so. All right.
No,
I think Rocco. I think
and he shouldn't for his own good.
No.
GP?
Yep.
Rocco is upset at GP for what?
Because I got stirred into the mix.
No,
as usual.
You didn't get stirred into the mix. I introduced you guys. Look, I introduced you guys. You could have done your own show and everything else. You guys didn't get introduced into any mix.
What I mean by that is, you know, this whole court thing and
yes, I forgot where this was going.
How did you get introduced?
When I would try to wiggle out of talking about it, it would be constantly brought up, and I'm like, I can't talk about that.
All right, GP, who was the first person to ever mention a court case to you?
Jake. Well. Rocco brought it up.
Oh, I thought Joker brought it up. I thought Joker was the one who told you how you could actually do it.
He was telling me how to. He was telling me how to keep them from getting into my videos and shit, taking clips of my stuff.
Okay.
Where you could hide all your shit. Yeah.
You know, and then. The whole court thing, you know, and
you know,
I don't know anything.
I don't know. Yeah, please explain
about this whole court thing. I don't know.
You know, the whole court thing happened.
I don't know who came up with it? I know all the people that ran with it and continued the lie, but I don't know who actually thought it was real and who actually brought it up in the first place.
There is an actual court case against them.
With the Roloff family?
The Roloff family. Them and the channel
did you read about that somewhere or what?
I am actually in contact with the Roloff family.
Crazy. Oh.
Because I do know them.
What part of the Roloff family are you in contact with?
Matt.
Oh, the father. Yeah.
The patriarch.
This is so insane. Just such a crazy lie. Such an unbelievable crazy lie.
Discovery Channel, I think it is, that they are on.
You're in contact with the Discovery Channel? Is going after them.
Whatever. I know they went after the History Channel.
Yeah, whatever. Can we please stop talking about this?
Discovery Channel is going after
History. The History Channel and the Discovery Channel went after Tards on Deck, or they tried to flag them for playing copyright material on YouTube.
Neither.
I guarantee you, they could flag them for that shit.
Yeah, we just know not to post it on a
picture of wrestling.
They could pull the whole video off just by dislikes.
Yeah, it won't even get posted. You know what I mean? If there's any issues, YouTube's thing won't let you post it. They've done it with a couple of the Walker episodes, but they've let a few of the Walker episodes through.
Yeah.
Matt was giving me a whole rundown on, you know, the company that they...
Dude, I'm like just... All right, here's the thing, Pickles.
Here's the thing we gotta do.
Or the channel that they deal with is going after them. They're going after them.
How long ago did you and Matt talk about this?
Me and Matt Roloff talked about this quite a few months ago.
Like last year, a few months ago, like this year.
I don't know where Mr. Blue is. Oh, it's Thursday night, so he's
basically
probably working.
Basically this year. Well, it's been within a 1-year period.
Gotcha.
Basically, within this year, within a 1 year period, she talked to Matt Rolfe.
So I was like, okay, you know. And
I love it.
Right, so Avery?
I was like, wow, you know, I said, you know, they've attacked me when I was streaming on another platform because they got caught playing your guys' content.
Do that over the dock.
They got shut down.
Friendo, he's got a new job. He has to get up at 3 in the morning. He can't do the stream right now.
He's got a new job. He has a kid.
He can't do the stream until he gets done with training for his new job where he has to get up at 3 in the morning every day, except for Sundays.
I said,
he's in bed every night at 7, he tells me.
This whole thing's been ongoing with me.
Oh, I wish, LMAO. I wish.
And
that'd be so crazy.
You know, Matt.
Wait, hold on. To some...
How much stress it's put on his family because of these guys. And
it's weird that, like, just outsider's perspective, it's weird that somebody like Matt would have a hard time dealing with, you know, small criticism from a small channel like TOD, and they were on like the History Channel and the Discovery Channel. Like, I feel like with fame, there's a certain level of.
They would get letters.
It's being too rational.
Letters from fans.
Hey, how weird.
They would get letters from fans.
Would tell them about
fan mail
that was being said.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know,
crazy.
Does TOD have that big of an audience? I don't even know what they're.
Yeah, like 200 views.
I'm pretty sure after this video, I'm gonna have the first video of mine up there. After
that's true.
It's because of what's being said. It's not because that you're on here.
Now, hold on, GP. Before I forget. How did you end up meeting up with Joker? Was it because of TOD that you became friends with Joker or a follower? Or
no, me and Joker. I ended up getting tangled into. There was one lady from Canada. Me and her became close.
Say her name, Lady Crocheter.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, but she's a.
I remember a lady was from Canada.
This gets really good.
Okay.
Yeah. And you know. I would send her stuff. She would send me stuff. I would help her on her channel. I would come up on her panel and help her out because she was always so nervous being up there by herself. Me and her started doing panels together. And then.
Yeah, no, more like Pickles would hijack the panel, make it all about herself.
Yeah, and Lady could do shows on her own, and she would get so fucking mad when Pickles would take over the stream.
Yeah.
It ended
when we would comment and say it's the Pickles and Lady show, and she'd be like, yeah, there's the Ladies and Pickles, my stream.
Women's group, which I got sucked into another one.
I remember one of them now. Was it Blue Eyed Diva? Was one of them?
When I was with the first girls group, yeah.
Okay. All right. Was that what? I think she might have been one of the ones that came on Pesci's show then. Okay.
Shout out to Blue Eyed Diva.
Nice.
She's been totally nice to everybody. She's been in Jacob. And
yeah, she has been very nice.
The whole thing with her was...
Pickles has been very, very not nice to Diva.
I told her,
you're lying about being raped by your father. You know,
if you ever
or a homeless man or whatever,
reach out and message me. I've got a messenger. Here's my
Pickles
number.
Is just evil.
You know, here's my Twitter. You know, blah blah blah. Me and this one girl group invited her up to watch movies with us on Zoom calls.
What a Blue Eyed Diva loves us.
And
see? Got her a Zordon.
You know, we ended up bringing her into this group, and then we had this one lady that came in, and she ended up taking over the group, telling everybody what channel
who
we
is
could
she
watch,
talking
what channel
about?
We couldn't watch.
I don't know.
You know, yada,
so
yada,
Blue
yada.
Diva, that might be the other lady who came on Pesci's.
And
that sounds about right.
I think Schmidt's thinking of Uber Goober.
Blue-eyed
Uber
Diva
Goober for sure, but there was two of them, they said, so I don't know who else.
I don't think it was Blue-eyed Diva.
No, I do not think so at all. I think it might have been Linz and John Paranormal.
Oh, yeah, the fame whores.
Blue-eyed Diva, I don't think wants to really talk about it on stream.
No.
Involved with another female. And the girl that he was involved with reached out to me. So I pulled Diva in. I pulled a couple of other ladies in. And I pulled up a mutual friend of ours, male.
Diva's probably going to comment on this video and explain what she's talking about here. So I look forward to it. Because I have no idea what pickle.
Probably leave like 10 comments.
That's fine though.
One after the other. Yeah. It's usually
all our streams. Our stream. This video is not complete until it gets posted on YouTube and people comment, and I can get the full story.
Yeah.
That's how our stream.
Flat out told the guy. I said, look, stay the hell away from her. Leave her alone. Don't contact her again. I said.
Now is she talking about Hendrick?
I don't know, but listen to this.
My face will be the last thing you see at your door.
Hendrick.
You don't want that.
Hendrick the gas huffer.
Listen to this. Listen to what she says, though.
And I said, you know, people in Canada go missing every day.
Blue-eyed Diva's not from Canada.
Well.
Yeah, no.
She was constantly awesome. Crying and nagging. Well, this guy don't do this. This guy that I'm seeing is doing this, and he's not calling me every 5 minutes. And
yeah, Hendrick. I'm like,
people what? Have jobs.
Yeah, legend, people have lives.
Gas huffer.
Exactly.
Hey, people have lives. You know, they have to like, you know, breathe and eat and shit and sleep and shower and fuck and whatever right. In their own discrepancies.
You sleep through these days.
Well, you know, here's the thing, Jacob. Why is Jody with you?
Now, Diva ended up.
I can be your man.
Blue Eyed Diva ended up hooking up with this other guy who lives in the same state and he's just right around the corner from her.
Stop. Why are we talking about who she hooks up with?
Well, anyway.
Because Pickles loves doing that.
I finally got fed up with it because they have not met face to face or this, that, and other.
You got fed up with her relationship?
I can't deal with your issues. If you guys hook up, y'all hook up, meet up, whatever. You know, I have my own issues.
I think DK is still on DLive.
Oh, yeah. Where is DK?
I ended up, and Jake will tell you.
Now, did Diva say something about,
this is so awesome.
She tried to call you out on your, psychic abilities or.
No.
Intuition or some shit.
I love that this guy, Schmidt, has seen all of our videos
on
Pickles.
One night.
I like that.
I feel bad now.
I know we've said some very terrible things about him, but he had a list. Of things that he held Pickles accountable
for. I feel bad because I've called Schmidt a faggot like several times.
Very horrible things.
She called me up
this
on Messenger and
video is very good. Or like just the way he just.
There's this going on in my backyard. There's this.
I feel bad. I apologize.
There's a cat
to Schmidt
out of nowhere
because he's doing a good job here. Just fucking.
I told her,
and
I
this
was
is
like,
funny.
Look,
just the psychic
this
thing.
This is what's going on across the street from your house. This is what's going on in the back of your house. And the cat that appeared out of nowhere, that's Bathsheba. You know,
what?
I said, if these spirits hear you talking to me about them.
Yeah, I do refresh it. It doesn't
you,
look.
And they're going to come after me.
Mine fixed. I fixed
oh,
mine.
Oh, okay.
I said, the best thing for you to do, go in your house, lay down and go to bed. And get off the phone with me.
Now, hold
so
on,
she
DP.
Goes in the house. She goes in the house. And she tells me, okay, I'm in the house. I was like, okay, good night. And I hung up.
spirits are going to get her.
Never heard from her again about it.
No, this is more on the serious part for GP. Now, GP, you said you run your church group or whatever.
Are yeah, everyone said that Schmidt seems is like, a nice guy.
Like a senior member. There's other people there.
No, we're just assholes.
Yeah, we're just horrible people.
We're just jerks.
Welcome everybody in, and I'm the one that talks and shares my story and.
GP, Jason Marshall said he'll message you tomorrow.
Okay.
The boss.
Hold on, before we go, Jacob.
Yeah, they play. Didn't you
say that Jason Marshall was the secret boss?
Okay, that's what we said, right?
At some point, Jacob.
Didn't we say he was the final boss or the secret boss?
Yeah, Jacob Marshall. Yeah, he's our boss. We work for Jacob.
Well, I thought in like the end Jason. Of like the video game, he's like the secret boss. Or the
oh yeah, boss. Probably. Yeah.
Somebody said that.
On one of those videos. I don't know. I just.
That's, and the best thing is Jason Marshall is like the one who kicked all of this off.
He said.
Because.
Hey. Don't.
And, Jacob Waters plays. I didn't play it because I didn't want us to sit here and listen to the entire song. They listened to the most recent Jason Marshall song, the Truth Shocker song, and she thinks
those are good.
And she thinks it's funny, but that's what started everything because those songs. She threatened him. She said, "Take those down," or yeah. something. Or I'm getting a lawyer or something like that.
She's just and all over the place.
He said, like, fuck you, bitch. Like, contact or tell your lawyer to contact me, something. And then took the videos down. So she just assumed that a lawyer had reached out and contacted him. Or something like that.
Yeah. That's along what.
Those lines. Because then he reached out to us and said, basically, hey, like, just Pickle so you guys Six know. Is a lawsuit. Yeah. He's like, do what you want with this info. And it was just like, well,